Are you all right?
Are you okay?
I don't think my gaskets can take much more of this.
You need to take more care, Lofty. We were demolishing those walls just as you arrived.
I wanted to know if there was somewhere quieter I could work.
Quieter? We're drilling, smashing and knocking things down. That's a noisy business.
This isn't like you, Lofty. Is something wrong?
I suppose I'm a bit nervous about blowing up the chimney.
It is going to be very loud, but it's the last thing we'll do. We'll let you know when it's happening, so don't let it worry you.
Okay, Bob. I'll try not to.
Have you removed all the girders yet? Two-ton's gonna take them away for recycling.
I'll finish that now. Thanks, Bob. Scoop! Are you around here? Demolition Scoop! Thank goodness. But it wasn't funny, Scoop.
What happened?
I was just having a joke with Lofty, but maybe I did one kaboom too many.
Scoop, you should never joke around on a demolition site.
I know, Wendy, but I got carried away.
And now look what I've done.
This is a problem. The chimney's been weakened on that side. If we blow it up now, it'll fall into the street.
Does this mean you can't blow it up, Bob?
Using explosives is the only way to bring it down safely, Lofty. But first, we're going to have to make sure it falls the right way. We'll start by patching up that hole.
We're going to need a scaffold to get up there.
We'll all help, Bob. Yes, and no more joking around, I promise.
OK, team, this chimney is priority number one. Let's work quickly but safely.
Got it, Bob.
Got it, Bob.
Okay, in this storm, Bob.
Don't worry, they'll be fine.
Where's Mr. Bentley?
I'm still metal, Mr. Bentley.
Ah, yes. Sorry, Philip.
Everyone okay?
Oh, no problem, Bob.
I had a lovely nap.
I've never felt so filthy in my entire life.
We're fine, Bob.
Right, let's have a look at these sand sculptures.
Yay!
What a relief. How long have we got to finish off the sculptures?
Just 10 minutes. I'm sure about that.
What can we make in 10 minutes?
Oh, that's brilliant.
Thanks. Oh, it was all my dad's idea.
Well done. Wonderful.
Super.
Very impressive.
Fantastic. Never mind. It's the taking part that counts.
Huh? Well, Wendy, I think we've finally found something we can't build.
It's time to announce our worthy winners, Leo and Curtis!
Huh? Yeah!
Well done!
Well done!
you.
Oh.
Sorry, Mayor Madison.
Oh.
Come on, you can wash the sand off at the tap. No way!
I don't believe it.
Take us up, Lovely!
Dinosaur boarding cowboy.
We did it!
It's not over yet, Lofty. We need to hurry and get the park finished. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
Madison, we're almost ready for your visit to Dino Park.
Excellent, Bob. I'm so looking forward to seeing it.
As am I. The beasts of the Cretaceous era are a special interest of mine.
Especially our prized Triceratops. The Riverdale models don't move, you know.
Oh, sorry. I've forgotten something. Just wait 2 minutes.
Okay, guys, we're done.
Not quite.
Huh?
What?
Why is it not making any noise? The fool must have broken its roar.
And the mayor is here. There's no time to fix it.
Wait! I know someone who can make a good roaring noise.
Who's it then?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
No problem, Bob. I'm just glad you finished the park in good time. Shall we? Oh, very impressive. Oh, that's brilliant. Fantastic! Ooh. Isn't it meant to make a sound?
Ooh.
Yes, well, I'm not certain Triceratops would have sounded like that.
It sounded very realistic to me.
Well, that pretended to be a dinosaur.
Where did Scoop and Lofty go? Were you scared?
Maybe just a little.
I wasn't. I was, helping Lofty.
Then there's only one way.
Here you go, Bob! Go, Bob!
Watch out for my snowman!
I just wanted to have fun on the snow like everyone else.
Maybe I could make it up to you by building you a really big jump.
Yes, please. That would be totally...
extreme?
Yeah.
Sounds like a plan, Scoop. We'll set up the night skiing lights while you build the jump. Let's go. We'll be right back.
welcome to the Winter and Spring Festival!
Prize in the snowman contest.
Meet Snow Bob. It's modelled on you.
It's like looking in a mirror.
Hey, super snowboarding Bob. You caught some big air up there.
Thanks, Guy. Maybe winter's not so bad after all. Although I am still looking forward to summer.
Great. Then I can teach you how to water ski.
Right. That does sound very wicked.
Have a problem. The parachute is torn and there isn't a spare.
Stella can't go into space without her parachute, otherwise she won't be able to come back home safely.
Bob, I think I know how to fix it.
Lofty, really carefully, please. Well done, Lofty. Let's get over to Mission Control.
Now.
There!
It was a great idea to use the banner to patch the parachute, Lofty. You saved the launch and Stella's coming down in a safe area, just like I planned.
Well done, Lofty. Well done, May.
Thank you, Bob. Stella's a record breaker.
If you feel like breaking another record, May, could you build a rocket so I can be the first crane into outer space?
Lofty,
the space crane.
Interesting proposal. Let's see. Yes, I could.
Leo?
Let's rumble. Watch this.
The skate bowl? Leo, wait!
Oh, no! How do I stop?
Are you okay, Leo?
Yes, thanks, Wendy. I'm fine. But what about the skate bowl?
Oh, no!
It's ruined!
And so's our video.
Oh, sorry. I shouldn't have gone into the bowl on my first day of skating.
Wait a minute. This was your first day, Lightning, Leo.
Sort of. Maybe. Yes.
Not to worry, Rockets. I think I know what we can do with that fresh load of cement.
Dizzy, the wickedest thing on four wheels is definitely you. You should be in the video.
Are you serious? Thanks, Leo. Maybe you could film it with your camera thingy.
Done it without you, Dizzy.
Or without Leo's extra camera work.
Right, anyone up for some more skateboarding?
Bring it!
Oh, hello, Gull. Mr. Bentley says the inspector could be anyone who comes near the beach. But who is it? No, probably not. Them either. No, wait! What if there are two inspectors? What if they've got cameras hidden in their sandwiches? Maybe not. Maybe they're just having their lunch. Look out for the inspector, girl! Inspector, he's here. That must be him. Oh no! Inspector! The inspector calls.
Huh?
Be careful, Muck.
Stop!
Oh, Muck, what are you doing?
The inspector.
What's going on, Muck?
He's over there. Taking photos of the beach. See? It's the Blue Ribbon Inspector.
Huh? He's a bird watcher, Muck. I think the only thing he's inspecting is the bird life.
Oh, so he's not the Blue Ribbon Inspector after all.
No.
Oh, I panicked, didn't I?
I think you did. But why? There was no need to.
Mr. Bentley and Lofty are so good at keeping things tidy, you see? And I'm just so messy. I thought if the beach wasn't clean and tidy in time, we wouldn't get a blue ribbon.
But I've told you before, there will be time to tidy up afterwards. We always leave our building site safe and clean.
Tidying up before we've finished means it'll take even longer to get it done.
Yes, I see that now.
Will we be able to finish the beach in time for the inspection, Bob?
Yes, if we work steadily and don't panic.
So, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
lights are going to look great, Wendy.
Well, let's test them and see.
Hey, Wendy, I'm about to start making the snow. Can you help me carry the bottles of fluid?
Sure. I'm all finished here.
Bob is here, and the tree lights are twinkling. This is the perfect time to give him his Christmas present.
Now, Lofty. You're ruining the display.
But I'm trying to find it.
Lofty, you're in the way.
No, where is it? Never mind. Bob's gone. I'll find it later.
Come on, Lofty, let's finish the display. Yet?
Not yet. Once the fluid is in, the machines need to be switched on.
Oh, then is there snow?
Not quite. The machines churn up the fluid to make tiny white bubbles that stick together, and that makes the pretend snow.
All done. Do you two want to go down and watch the snow fall over the tree?
Woo-hoo! I'm gonna see it snow!
I think that's a yes from Leo.
The display is almost finished and I've still not given Bob his present.
We're gonna test the snow machines.
Are you coming to watch?
Oh yeah, sure am.
Definitely.
I'll be there in a minute.
Oh, Lofty, please don't mess up the display again.
I won't.
I'd love to give Bob his Christmas present when it's actually snowing.
Ready, Leo? This is your chance to be a real cowboy and round up those horses.
And they're in top gear!
Don't worry, I grew up with horses. Here's what we're going to do. Lofty, extend your crane arm as far as you can and as fast as you can. We're going to make a barrier and steer them back into their paddock.
Grew up with horses, Wendy.
Oh, yes, I rode them all the time. Wooden ones on the merry-go-round.
Huh?
Well, Bob, that was smart work getting my horses back. I hope you've got another good idea about how to get them into these stables before dark.
There's nothing for it but hard graft and starting over. We'll get them rebuilt, even if it takes all night.
Oh, Muck. I've let everybody down. The stables would be finished by now if I hadn't scared the horses. A real cowboy would never do that. Only there was something I could do to make up for it.
Right, here's the plan. Wendy and Lofty will stay on site with me to rebuild the stables. Leo,
You can take Scoop and Muck back to their garages. At least some of us can get a good night's sleep.
Even if the horses don't. All that galloping and now nowhere for them to sleep. Oh, they'll be too tired to even walk around the track tomorrow.
Nowhere for them to sleep. Hang on, Bob. Yeah? No, Pilchard, it's not for you.
Good night, Muck.
Night, night, sleep tight. Make sure your brakes on right.
Thank you for giving up your bays for the night.
You were right, Leo. Our machine bays are just like horse stables, just bigger.
Yep, three bays for three tired horses. Three buckets of oats and three buckets of water. I feel like a real cowboy now.
Yeah. Look at us all sleeping under the stars. It's just like the Wild West.
Well done, Cowboy Leo. You made that into a real Wild West roundup. Wasn't supposed to happen, was it?
Oops. The bear's arriving on the next plane. Are you ready? Are you ready? Bob, where did the bear's habitat go?
Don't worry, Jenny. Just a little hiccup with the foundations. Bob will put it right.
What happened, Scoop?
I'm so sorry, Bob. I just wanted to give the big, fierce mountain bear a big, tall mountain to live on so that it would be happy.
Sorry, Bob.
I'm really sorry too, Bob. I should have known better.
No, Lofty, I persuaded you to build it higher. I'm sorry, it really is all my fault.
Jenny's in a panic. I hope you have a backup plan, Bob.
I didn't design the mountain to be as tall as Scoop wanted, but I do like his idea.
Brilliant!
Yes, and?
If we use shingle and concrete as the base instead of shingle and soil, we could build four different levels instead of three. Can you fetch us some quick drying concrete, Two-Ton?
I can bring some now, Bob, before I collect the bear.
Thanks, Two-Ton.
You're very welcome.
And then we'll all have to work extra hard to get it finished.
We will, Bob.
Anything you say.
You can count on us.
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can.
Hasn't been built.
person your size. It's for little robots only.
We're going to get you down, but you mustn't move a muscle, OK?
Or I'm in the movies. I've got to move.
Leo!
B11D!
Are you all right? I'm OK, I think.
Are you sure you're not hurt?
I'm fine, but look what I've done to the rocket.
Looks like that's the end of D11D. Hooray! Sorry.
And the end of my film. Oh no, I'm so sorry.
Better?
I'm okay, except I'll never see Space Robots 3, and nor will anyone else.
Unless we can think of a way to fix D11D.
We build an all-new D11D. D12D.
I'm afraid a new robot would take months to build rather than hours.
What about if we clean up D11D, put him on wheels, and move him around with ropes?
Except the audience will see the ropes, and that's not a good look for a space robot.
Oh, poor Safi. Now she's never going to meet her robot hero. Hey, wait a minute. Safi can do the D11D noises perfectly.
And she's about the same size. Are you thinking what I'm thinking, Leo?
I think so, Bob.
Wendy, can you get the rocket back up and the set in shape? If Leo and I sort out the D11D problem...
With the help of these guys, I can.
In that case, there's only one thing to say. Action!
Nobody knew is that something strange lurked in the woods.
Then what happens, Leo?
I can see a campfire! Come up, Leo!
It rumbled and grumbled in the darkness. It had eyes so big and bright they could blind you, and a cry so terrifying that it could turn your hair white.
Overnight!
Don't
like the
sound of that! Don't be silly, Muck! Your light's on if you're scared.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ah!
The creature!
Silly. And please let go of my hand. Both of you.
I was just trying to make you feel safer.
I think we should stay here till the lights have gone.
Shall I hold your hand, Leo?
Hello.
doing here?
Thank goodness we're home.
I was so scared. Were you dizzy?
Where is Dizzy?
I thought she was behind you.
So did I. We have to go back and look for her.
Not on our own. It's too scary. We'll have to wake Bob up. Bob! Wake up!
Bob! Now what?
Wake up!
Bob, we did something silly.
And we've lost Dizzy.
Really sorry, Dizzy.
We didn't realise you weren't with us until we got back to the yard.
Are you okay, Dizzy?
I'm fine. But he isn't.
Nothing could go wrong.
Maybe you would like an ice cream.
Here's the new window, Bob.
Excellent. Okay, everyone. We need to get those penguins into their new pool as soon as possible.
Can we fix it?
This reminds me of the time in Pettigrew.
We'd like to keep up.
As soon as that window's fixed, we can take these penguins back to the zoo.
Whoa!
Right over there. Hey, get back in that pond. Turns up Mayor Madison's special guest.
Really likes penguins.
Oh,
the finest food with the best views in
Spring City. That's why Mayor Madison has arranged for you to come back to the zoo and officially open our new penguin pool.
It appears to be moving.
I'd always intended it to be the highlight of your visit.
It's a revolving restaurant.
Oh, yes, please, I love that.
Magnificent miracle of mechanical engineering.
What have you
fancy a plate of haggis and leaves?
Ooh. I feel sick.
I now declare Spring City's new Antarctic penguin experience well and truly over.
This visit is a complete disaster. I thought you said nothing could go wrong.
This has been the best visit ever. Thank you so much, Mayor Madison. And thank you, Mr. Bentley.
Oh, I wish that penguin pool was ready.
And thank you.
This reminds me of the time
you saved the day.
Where's Bob? What's happening?
Mayor Townley is visiting next week. Really? I hear him at the elephant.
What's going on here? Who is responsible for this disgrace? This outrageous circus!
Well, I am.
And you laid on this wonderful treat.
Just for me. Thank you so much.
We like to keep our visitors happy. Uh-oh. Hi, Bob. Turns out Mayor Madison's special guest really likes penguins.
Oh, right. And that's why Mayor Madison has arranged for you to come back to the zoo and officially open our new penguin pool.
I'd always intended it to be the highlight of your visit.
Oh, yes, please, I'd love that. Marvellous. Well, come on, everybody. What are we waiting for?
Get out! Get out! We're flopping about!
Watch out, Scoot! Slow down!
Oh, thank goodness it's gone.
What's going on?
Oh, I'm going to fall in. Help!
It's okay, Lofty. You're not going to fall. Stay calm. Slowly drive forwards.
It's not working.
Oh. None of Lofty's wheels are touching the ground, Bob.
What are we going to do?
It's a shame we can't just reel him in like a fish.
Hang on a minute. That gives me an idea. Lofty, don't move. Just do exactly what I say.
Uh-huh.
Scoop, come forward really slowly so that your front bucket is below Lofty's hook.
Uh-huh.
Lofty, let your hook drop so Scoop can carry it. Wendy, Leo, go with Scoop and attach Lofty's hook to the base of the spar. You'll be fine, Lofty.
Ready, Bob?
Okay, stand back now. Now, Lofty, start pulling your hook in really slowly. That's it, you're doing fine. And now, drive forward very gently. Yeah! Well done, Lofty.
Thank you, Bob. I'm sorry, Lofty. I shouldn't have been messing about by the river. I put Lofty in danger and we've lost part of the bridge. The race will be ruined now.
Don't worry, Scoop. You helped put things right too.
Did I?
Yes. You said we should reel Lofty in like a fish, and that's exactly what we did.
Except Lofty hasn't got ugly teeth and spikes down his back.
We'll get the bridge finished in time if we all work together. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
I put the team in danger, all because I couldn't concentrate on one job at a time.
You managed it in the end.
And saved the train.
But what are we going to do about the station and the track?
There's just enough time before the train makes its first journey. So, can we fix it?
Yes, we can.
Yes, we can.
Start your engines! Ready? Steady? Go!
done this time?
I'm sorry, Bob. I just wanted to be like Skye and break a record.
Well, you definitely broke something.
Oh, dear. The fun run starts in an hour, and we haven't even finished the rope bridge.
Ew.
Uh-oh. Oh, no.
The game's not over just yet, team. We can fix this if we draw on our best abilities. Lofty, I'll need your amazing weightlifting strength.
Sure thing, Bob.
And Muck, I'll need your powerful bucket.
No sweat.
What's wrong, Scoop?
Oh, I messed up everything for Skye's fun run. And I wasn't very good at sports either.
And Scoop?
Yes, Bob?
You're an all-round all-star. I'll need your speed, ability and digging power.
Yes, Bob!
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
That's the sporting spirit!
The most important thing about a fun run is to have fun! And eat your broccoli. Go!
So myself.
Bob's right. I should just try to get some rest. Must get some sleep. Maybe I should try counting sheep. Oh no, they're boring. I'll try tires. One, two. What is that smell? Yikes!
Nearly there, Bob. We don't want all this lovely ice cream melting.
Nearly there, Chef Tutty.
Bob, it's Scoop. It's an emergency.
Another one, Scoop? Did you get some rest?
No, but there's a fire, Bob. A fire in the yard.
Look, Scoop.
You need to get rest. Otherwise, you're going to keep on exaggerating these
small problems.
But Bob!
Rest, Scoop. Over and out.
Got to save the yard. But what do I do? Oh, I can pick it up because I'm made of metal. So, if Bob won't come to the fire, I'll have to take the fire to Bob. He'll know how to put it out. Oh, no!
You've got some amazing types of ice cream here, Chef Tetty.
Thank you. I invented them myself.
Do people prefer the pizza flavour to the sardine and spinach flavour?
We'll never know, Lofty, if we don't get them in the freezer soon. They'll melt.
Fire! Fire!
OK, try not to panic, Scoop. Drop it onto the sand. Get back, everyone!
This is a real, real emergency! But I must put the fire out! Oh, the sea's too far away! I've got it!
Great idea, Scoop! Quick, Muck, copy Scoop!
Will do, Bob!
Well done for putting the fire out, Scoop. But you should never pick something up that's on fire.
I know, Bob, but I was so tired and confused.
Still, I should have listened to you when you said it was an emergency.
Yeah, but I should never have exaggerated so much. I'll never, ever, ever exaggerate again in my whole life, ever.
What's done is done.
You saved the yard, and luckily, only the roof's ruined.
What about the ice cream? In half an hour, it'll be completely melted.
Half an hour, you say? We can do that.
So you can fix this?
Yes, we can!